What's up, everyone? I'm Brad Thompson here with Kremin Inc, and today we're going to give you a quick demo on our automated parts carousel. Great concept, good idea. Definitely a way that you could improve your quality, reduce your cost, if it worked right. This is an automated parts carousel, meaning it's a component that sits at the end of your machine and it collects pieces and can rotate without any sort of effort or manual input from a person. This one here happens to be the model ST22, ST meaning smart table. It's manufactured by PressureTech and distributed by iSwiss. These units come in two sizes. Again, this is the ST22. There's an ST15 as well. The ST22 has these 14 parts catchers on top. The ST15 only has 6. It really depends on the footprint of the area you have on which one you want to utilize. They all come with 3 modes of operation. They can either be set on a timer, a parts counter, or hook it up directly to the machine and utilize M-code. Now, if you work in a shop, you've probably seen an automated parts carousel before. The reason we've gone with this unit specifically was because we're able to recycle the oil. If you look at these bins, you'll notice these perforated holes. These perforated holes obviously allow the oil to drain into the machine. And then on the bottom, there's a hose that we've snaked back into our machining center so that we can recycle the oil throughout the week. As I said before, this is a quality tool. The whole idea here is that you don't have to manually come back and forth between what you're doing and the parts coming out of the machine to make sure you don't got a big pile piling up. As the parts come out, they get collected in these bins. You set the machine up to go on, again, counters or a timer or M-code from the machine, such that it'll collect a certain number, whatever you set it to, and then eventually this carousel will rotate to the next bin. That saves the operator, again, from having to come down, check on things every so often. Now, also helps with quality, because if you can imagine you just had a bucket here and you went all day making parts and one of them ended up being bad, now you've got possibly thousands of parts to sort through. Whereas here, you've got lots of a significantly smaller quantity, 20 to 50, whatever you want to set it at. But if you encounter an issue, now you're only sorting 20 parts as opposed to thousands. You're going to save on time. You're going to save on scrap. Ultimately, it's going to improve the quality going out of your shop and save you a couple bucks in the end. These don't come without their drawbacks. This ran us about $5,000, and for as much as I spent on it, I expected a little bit better quality. The issue I have with it is that its whole main purpose is to collect parts reliably, and right now it doesn't do that. I'm gonna show you why. If you watch, you'll notice there's a lot of slop or compliance in this machine here. It's got a proc switch over in the corner that's counting to make sure that when it rotates the correct amount to go to the next bin. However, because it has so much slop, if you let this go and you don't keep an eye on it for too long, it's possible you could end up something like that, and now you got parts all over the floor. That I can't have. For something that's meant to be a quality device, it's causing me quality issues unless I keep an eye on it. It's a great concept, awesome way to try and collect parts in a way that's gonna improve quality and reduce cost. Unfortunately, quality of the machine itself just isn't quite there yet. But in the future, if those small things can be cleaned up, you might see a lot more of these in our shop.